Hi! In this video, I'm gonna show you how I converted Jaguar X-Type instrument cluster to work with Arduino. It started when I bought Dirt 4 on Steam summer sale. I really liked the game, but I couldn't stand illegible and misplaced HUD. Searching for solution, I remembered about SimHub software, which, in simplification, allows you to output game data into various devices like Arduino. I wanted to make myself a challenge, so I started searching for quirky instrument cluster that have documentation available online. I found Jaguar X-Type 2-liter diesel instrument cluster for 20 zlotys. When it arrived, I modified connectors to connect standard 12-volt power supply. Next step was to make the needles move, so I bought a cheap CAN-bus model for Arduino. CAN-bus is a type of network which is mostly used in cars for communication between various models. After connecting model to the cluster, uploading an example sketch, I received a few headers and unfortunately my luck ended here. I realized that to move the needles I must know how the headers for the speed, RPM, etc. look like in the CAN-bus. Documentation and internet did not provide such information. I even asked on Jaguar X-Type forums, but with no luck. The only way to get this data is sniffing the CAN-bus in a car, reading headers, sorting them, and defining which does which. I decided not to give up and started disassembling the cluster. I found out that the needles are driven by small X25 stepper motors. Quick googling, and it turned out that there are many tutorials and projects showing how to use them with Arduino. The video and article by Ardunaut, as well as questions from comments, were especially helpful. The commentators suggested using receiver diodes to prevent burning the Arduino, and author himself quoted a link to the self-soldered type PCB by their engineer. The PCBs are not available for sale, but thankfully the whole project was open source. The GitHub link to the project is in the description. I used online software to open the PCB sketch, and after understanding its principle of operation, designed my own breadboard that allows me to use 4 stepper motors. I found an information that it's possible to use only 3 motors, since the Arduino has only 12 digital pins, 4 for each motor. That turned out not to be true, because you can use analog as digital pins, but attention, not all of them. More of that in a while. So what you see is the first prototype. The current consumption of the motors is so low they can be directly driven by Arduino. As you can see, I use digital pins to control the main needles and analog for the temperature and fuel gauges. After hacking directly into the instrument cluster PCB, 3 of 4 gauges were alive. The fuel gauge did not work. After a long time of debugging my board, I found that not all analog pins on the Arduino are equal, as you can see in this diagram. I decided to replace 2 analog for digital pins using jumper wires. The needle started moving, but it still wasn't working as it should. Replacing another 2 pins with digital solved the issue. Maybe the digital and analog pins shouldn't be combined. After this modification, all gauges worked as expected. I also added 12-volt connector for the backlight. This is the updated diagram of the breadboard, where analog pins of the fuel gauge were replaced with digital. I used diodes suggested by the author of the article, which are 1N4001. This diagram assumed tearing out 4 pins from the female connector or not soldering them to Arduino. Now it's time for programming the gauges. I am using Switek X25 library by Guy Carpenter. You can find the link in the description. First of all, we are defining the range of all 4 motors, creating the class instance for them using corresponding pins, and defining multipliers, which will allow to send data in suitable units. In the setup void, all gauges are set to 0 and serial communication is initialized. If you have problems with 0 method, you need to modify the variable called reset /step_microsec in the library code. I set it to 2000 and it works fine. In the loop void, we have two variables, next position and counter. Next position is used to store the value that the gauge will be set to, and counter represents the number of the gauge that is being set. If serial data is available, we read it char by char, but let's call a char symbol. If symbol is a number between 0 and 9, it is joined to the next position variable. If the symbol value is 59, which is value for semicolon, the next position variable is assigned for a specific motor, then it's zeroed, and motor counter is increased, so the next time semicolon happen, next motor value will be set. In the end, if the symbol means end of the line, both variables are zeroed and process starts from start. Every time the loop void is executed, the needles are updated to the value we set to them. And now I present to you working final product. As you can see, the instrument cluster is working, but I overestimated SimHub capabilities. SimHub relies on solutions provided by the developers team, which means it's really hard to connect your own project. Theoretically, it allows making custom string for sending data, but at the same time, it requires using previously prepared code to work with Arduino. That means I'm still stuck with the in-game HUD. If you have any ideas how to solve this problem, you can let me know in the comments. All diagrams, code, etc. are available on my GitHub page. Link is in the description. Hope I helped someone, and thanks for watching.